In this video, we are going to decode 4 types of storefronts. Let's do it.
Thanks for watching windowcleaner.com.
So the 4 types of storefronts that we are going to decode in this video are salons, dry cleaners, restaurants, and retail. Number 1 is film. Every salon is going to get a film on the inside. It's because of the product that they use. The hair dryers are blowing stuff everywhere. You need a good microfiber.
Every salon you'll find gets film on the inside.
I would recommend the Unger 4000 HD. Number 2 for salons is mirrors. You want to try to upsell the mirrors and just have a minimum of, mine is $25, and then it goes up from there depending on how many stations they have. See if they want their mirrors done. You're going to have to work around the product that the stylist keeps on their table. You're gonna have to move that stuff away, clean behind it, and then move it back. It's a pain, don't underestimate it. You also, with mirrors, are gonna find yourself having to work around the stylist sometimes. Become friends with the stylist.
Okay. All right, Vic, let's get to it. This guy doesn't have all day.
I'm waiting for you the other way.
Okay, number 2 is dry cleaners. You're going to find that insects love dry cleaners on the inside. They love it, love it, love it. And when you're doing an initial clean on a dry cleaners, you're going to have dead flies, dragonflies, bees, wasps, hornets, stink bugs. There's one that I do once a month, and it doesn't matter. There's spider webs on the outside, there's bugs on the inside, there's droppings all over the tops of the windows, and it's always the tops of the windows that you have to look for. So that's going to require extra scrubbing. It may require a second clean because you don't get everything the first time. Awkward workspaces. You're going to be in tight spaces, you're going to be working over sewing stations, you're going to be working maybe against the clothing. I have had a dry cleaner where I actually had to squeeze myself in between the windows and the clothes. You're going to deal with people coming in and out constantly. There's one that I do, they have these door chimes, and so every time I move, I have to move the door chime so that it's against the wall, the sensor, because it keeps going off over and over and over and over again. It's so annoying. You may also have to deal with automatic sliding doors. Drive-through windows, even though there's a small amount of glass, it may take you the longest to clean. You're gonna have the sliding windows where the food and money is exchanged. You may have 2 windows on either side, a top window above those windows, and then 2 windows on the side so that the person can see what's coming and going from the drive-through. Not only that, the drive-throughs are cramped, they're usually very busy, and there is a skill and an art to learning how to clean these windows when the store is operating.
You want me to do it? There you go. Thank you. Plenty of room. You could fit another car in there. It's actually not a bad idea. You double them up and you just have them hand it through the car. You know.
Not only do you have to deal with the insides of that, you're also needed to deal with the outside, and you may actually have to cut cars in line, do 2 windows, step out of line, let the car get their food, cut the next car off, and you're literally standing in the drive-through waiting, and you have to work quickly and you have to work precisely. And then number 4 is being in the way. So I have a little phrase that I like to use. Learning the art of being in the way without being in the way. So you're gonna be in the way, whether it's a customer or whether it's a worker. How can you not be in the way? Let's take the workers for example. Learn their movements. Be aware of your surroundings. Customers, another point is to do the insides first, as much as you can get, do the outsides, and whatever you weren't able to get, inside will present itself. And our fourth and final storefront is retail. When I'm talking retail, I'm thinking mostly about clothing stores, but it can apply to other things. But the number one thing that came to my mind was dust. You're gonna find these huge dust bunnies on the sills of clothing stores. It's pretty simple to deal with, you know, but it may just make sure you have enough rags to do that. Number two is mannequins. But not all mannequins are created equal. Some of them are not put together, and they're held together by a string, literally. Be careful with mannequins. You can knock them over. They can fall apart in your hands. They may have accessories like a handbag or a briefcase or a hat that is carefully placed in there by the employee. And if you move it, it falls off and then you can't get it back up again. That is going to be time consuming. Not to mention working around them can really slow you down. Number three goes along with this, and that is cramped spaces. You may be working in some really awkward, cramped spaces. So you need to learn how to not have your tool belt catch signage that might be hanging from the ceiling, not knocking product over and merchandise with your tool belt, with your elbows. Well, that was enjoyable. I hope that was helpful to you as you go about your business. That was four storefronts decoded here on the Window Cleaning Resource Channel. I want to wish you a good day in your business. Be sure to tune in every week for new content from Window Cleaning Resource. And if you are interested in any of the products that were discussed or shown today, check the links below. Buy the gear, get the dough, and get on with life. So we wish you a good day in your business. We'll talk soon, and have a great day.